every single thing that you've gone through equips you to be able to do what you were born to do.
Welcome back to the Find Your Purpose Now podcast. I want to talk today about the purposes and assignments of other people. We've all known somebody who seems to just have the perfect life, the amazing life. Maybe it's exciting. Maybe it involves travel. Maybe it involves being around influential people or celebrities or politicians or whatever it is. We all know somebody who has more money than us. We all have somebody who has, maybe a better relationship, better marriage, happier life, whatever it is. It's so easy to find ourselves envying the life that somebody else has, especially when we're going through hard, hard things. And you look around and, you know, they're happy and, you know, they're posting all this amazing stuff on social media, and you're sitting there, you know, just wallowing in grief and sorrow and whatever else is going on in your life. I get it. I do. I have known people throughout my life who I loved, who were great friends of mine. But, you know, I look at their life and I'm like, wow, I think the hardest thing they've ever had to go through was, you know, getting their hair wet, walking from the car to the mall. You know, and in the meantime, I've had this crazy roller coaster, you know, gut tightened, holding my breath, white knuckle kind of life, a lot of my life. And so when I was younger and I didn't understand that we all have a different purpose, I'll tell you the truth. I mean, I was really envious of people who seemed like they had everything, they had it all going on, and, you know, and here I was. And I thought, well, I mean, God said that he has a good plan for us, a plan to prosper us and to be in good health and whatever. So in times where I felt like I wasn't prospering, and not just that I felt it, I wasn't prospering. And in times when I wasn't in great health, or, you know, whatever, and I didn't feel like what I was living was a good plan, it's easy to think, okay, well, I missed it. Somewhere along the line, I missed it. But we have to remember that everybody's life assignment is different. That's by design. We're all different by design. Think of your fingerprint, right? Your fingerprints are different than every one of the 7 billion plus human beings on Earth and the, I don't know how many human beings who have ever lived. You're different. I'm different. We think differently. Our perspectives are different. The combination of our character traits and personality traits, skills, talents, abilities, all those things that I've talked about before. If you haven't heard them, go back and listen to, you know, the other podcasts on gathering our data. But if you think about how all of that is different, it doesn't come as a great surprise then that our purpose is different and our life assignments are different. I think sometimes for us, it comes down to that, what do they say? FOMO, fear of missing out. That somebody else has got it better, more fun, more comfortable, easier. And that may be true. It probably is true. But that doesn't mean it's wrong that doesn't mean that you missed it. That doesn't mean that somewhere you took a wrong turn and, you know, now you're outside of God's amazing plan for your life and you don't know how to find your way back. No. Everything that we go through, whether it happened to us and was completely outside of our control, or it's as a result of the decisions that we made, God works it all together for good when we let Him, when we decide that that's what we're going to do, that we're going to trust God and cooperate and collaborate to let Him work everything together for good. That's that scripture. One of the very few scriptures that I could actually quote chapter and verse. It's Romans 8:28. So how do we do that? We work with God to mine the lessons out of the stuff we go through that doesn't feel good. And it's not complicated. It's just not always very comfortable. But the truth of the matter is, if we're going to go through something that hurts, we might as well learn something from it. Being angry about it, being bitter, letting it steal our joy and our happiness and our laughter and our smiles, that just makes it worse. So what do you do? Well, you just ask yourself and ask God to help you. What good came from the situation? Whatever it is, anything that doesn't feel good, that you're not happy about having to go through, what good could come from it? Or what good has come from it? Sometimes the answer to that is that our hearts are tenderized, that we're aware or more aware of the suffering of others that's going on in the world. So sometimes we wind up with greater empathy. I mean, hopefully we wind up with greater empathy and more wisdom, because it's in this process where we learn the difference between being hurt and being harmed. So if you're not sure about the distinction between those things, let me just spend a minute there. For example, if you go to the dentist, you know, none of us loves going to the dentist. I'm sorry to all the dentists out there. No disrespect intended. I love what you do, and I love when you do it really efficiently and quickly. But, you know, the dentist has to hurt you for a second to numb up the place where the dentist is going to work. And it hurts. It's uncomfortable. We don't like it. But the dentist doesn't intend to harm you. The little bit of hurt that you feel is so that you won't be harmed. There's intentionality involved with harm. When someone intends to hurt you, to do you wrong in some kind of way, that's harm. So back to your purpose being different from the next person's purpose, when God allows difficult things, painful things, it's usually because He's given us free will. That's the allowing part. He gave us all free will, and some of us don't handle it very well. and go through life hurting people and harming people. It's not that God did it, not that God wanted it to happen, but he didn't create a bunch of puppets and robots. He made us in his image, meaning he gave us a brain to think. He gave us a level of creativity to be able to create. He gave us this amazing ability to communicate with one another. I could go on and on. We're autonomous beings. We have free will. We have dominion and authority over ourselves, our actions, our thoughts, our feelings, our attitudes. And we can just walk right over others if we want to do that. Or if we're not paying attention and we do it without even understanding that we've done it. So if you find yourself going through something or living a life that's just really hard, not a matter of, you know, going through something temporarily, but that you're doing something that's difficult long term, that is your assignment. I'm thinking about people who care for ailing family members, somebody with Alzheimer's, a child that was born with mental or physical defects or both. And we say defect. I don't like that. Because, you know, we all have defects. None of us is perfect. But some people have exceptionally challenging lives, exceptionally difficult assignments. So it's not just a rough patch that they're going through. And maybe that's you. Maybe I'm talking to you right now. That it's a rough life. And it's hard. And you look around at other people who don't have it that hard. And it's really, really troubling. And it's so easy to be envious. I mean, it's human to look around and go, dang, why me? Why is this my assignment? I don't like it. This is hard. And I don't see it getting any easier anytime soon. What I can say is, trust God. Know that he must trust you to entrust you with such a hard, hard assignment and purpose. And we say things sort of flippantly, but there's, I think, sincere and significant truth to it when we say there's a special place in heaven for the people who love others who cannot or will not return that love. It's really, really hard. I'm thinking about someone, well, all the good foster parents in the world are amazing. Pastors, people who give their lives in the service of others. It's so hard, but I'm thinking about one beautiful woman friend who is a foster mom for medically fragile children. That's her specialty. She takes children who are severely disabled, mentally, physically, on ventilators. I mean, it's just unbelievable how this woman does this. I look at her and her life assignment, and I'm inspired, and I'm in awe, and I want to be a better person. And Mandy Litsky doesn't even know that I'm feeling this and thinking it. Every time I see her, every time I think of her, every time I see a social media post of hers. But it's the truth, and I know I'm not the only one. So if you're the person going through a really, really hard assignment, remember, you are going through. This is not our permanent home. Yeah, I mean, be as comfortable as you can. But don't think you're setting up permanent camp, because this life really is short. I know it doesn't feel like it when the minutes tick by like hours, because the assignment's so hard. But this is your assignment. Ask God for strength and grace, discernment, wisdom to know what to do, what to say. With a hard, hard life assignment like that, purpose, I would think that you have to be in constant communication with God. That's your lifeline. And really, that's the lifeline for all of us. It's just that when things are good and everything feels good and things are going along just fine, you know, sometimes we forget that we need God. We've got this going on. We're not going to bother God with our issues. We're not going to ask for help. But we should be every single day, because He perfectly matched us to our life assignment. He knows exactly where it needs to go. He knows exactly who you're influencing. And we're all influencing other people, for good or for bad. When we do the right thing, people are watching. When we do hard, hard things, people are watching. And when we're able to do those hard things with a smile on our face and just literally supernatural peace and joy, when we can bring peace into conflict, when we can smile in the middle of really hard, hard things, people are watching. We're modeling for others how it's done, how to live a good life, how to be a good person, how to be a good Christian. When we go through life looking at other people's life assignments and purposes and wishing that that's what we had, then we can't be happy for the other people who have those assignments. Envy blocks happiness and joy and peace. And those things accompany our purpose. God intends us to have healthy relationships with good people, a sense of wellness, like all is well with our souls, peace and joy, and the financial stability, consistency to be able to do what He created us to do. I want you to be happy about your purpose, not envious you don't have the easy life of somebody else. And you know what? The other piece to that is a lot of times we think people have an amazing life and we think they have it all going on. And if we really knew what was going on behind closed doors in their home, it might be different. A lot of times it is. We don't know what other people are going through. So that's it for today. Embrace your purpose. Ask God for help. And check back with me next week. We're going to keep walking this path until you find yourself in the sweet middle of God's beautiful purpose for your life. And you have all the good things that go along with it. All right, see you next week. The things that you've been through have changed the way you see the world. They've qualified you to do what you were born to do and perfectly matched to do. Is there anything more important than finding and living the purpose for which you were born? I don't think so. I think that's the point.